By the end of this tutorial, you will be able to do something really cool: view any web service running on your Raspberry Pi securely from anywhere in the world using Cloudflare tunnels. Like this Raspberry Pi camera I use to keep an eye on my valuables. Instead of using its local IP to access it, I will be able to check it from anywhere in the world by simply typing a subdomain into the web browser. To begin, let's get an account on Cloudflare. Then get a domain under the Register Domain subsection. After obtaining the domain, select the Zero Trust link to open up a new page. To set up the tunnel, go to the Tunnels page in the Access menu. Once you're there, you can create your first tunnel. Let's select a good, descriptive name for the tunnel we are about to create. After entering the name, you need to install the software to establish a tunnel. Fortunately, Cloudflare has made it easy with a simple command that you can copy and paste directly into your terminal. Be sure to opt for Debian as your operating system and pick the ARM 64-bit architecture. Looks like the 32-bit Raspbian distribution isn't compatible with Cloudflare Tunnel, because if you attempt to install it, an error stating that you've chosen the wrong architecture will show up. Therefore, if you have a Raspberry Pi 2 or an earlier version, you are out of luck.
I've been replaced!
I'm afraid so, but can you blame me? She's got triple the processing, all the latest software, and a sleek space-age design.
The next step is to select your domain name for your tunnel. You can optionally select a subdomain and path to personalize it. I want to share the web server service. The URL can be either localhost or 127.0.0.1, followed by a colon and the port number. Usually 80 or 443, if the web server serves the page using SSL. After creating the tunnel, you can find it in the tunnels list. The status column will also indicate if the tunnel is working correctly. When the web browser displays a bad gateway error message, it means that there is no web server running yet. To view a simple page, I am going to install NGINX as the web server on my Raspberry Pi, and then users will be able to see the web page hosted on it. To reinforce security protocols, it is possible to configure a firewall rule in the WAF section under the security menu of the website settings. This will help ensure that your data and digital assets remain secure. A new condition can be added to the firewall. This will check if the hostname matches the subdomain chosen as well as what IP address the request is coming from. If both conditions match, then the request will be blocked accordingly. For IP condition, select is not in from the operator dropdown and then add your current IP address to the list of values. This will ensure that your IP won't be blocked. If an outsider attempts to access a website hosted on your Raspberry Pi system, Cloudflare will prevent them from doing so. This ensures the security of your websites and data hosted on it. Check out this link to learn how to turn your computer into an IP camera for monitoring and keeping an eye on your belongings.